Good morning, students. Today I will start Interiors from class 7. It's very interesting chapter. So look here. Interiors. What is interiors? All negative and positive numbers are called integers. All negative and positive integers. So you must know about this. Negative and positive. One is negative, another is positive. All are called integers. I will give the example just like this. -4, -3, -2, -1, 0, after that 1, 2, 3, 4, dot dot dot. So there will be so many numbers. All negative and positive integers including 0 are called integers. So you have to know this. After that note, all negative integers are always less than positive integers. So I will give the example. Suppose -4. All negative integers is always less than positive integers. -4 less than 3. -2 less than 1. So all negative will be always less than positive integers. You must know about this. We will discuss sums also. Now next, what is absolute value of integers? The distance of any number, whatever numbers may be, from 0, is called absolute value. That means, suppose you start go from A to B and the distance is given 4 meter. So that is the absolute value. So we can write the example here. Look here, another example. Absolute value of suppose 4. Then we write this way. That is the symbol of absolute value. And it will be 4. Absolute value will be always plus sign. Suppose another question, the absolute value of -3. You will write this way. -3, after that give the mod sign. That is called also mod sign. But the real will be always 3. Okay. We can give the example also from here. Just see. Someone just go from O to A and distance is -3. But when you write the absolute value, the real will be 3. It will not be considered negative. So mod always returns positive. So you have to remember this. After that, we will discuss some questions from this exercise. So firstly, you must know the sum properties of sign. What is this property of sign? Plus into plus is equal to plus. You have to remember this. After that, minus into minus is equal to plus. So plus into minus is equal to minus, and minus into plus is equal to minus. So that is the sum property of integers, especially when you multiply, divide or assign. Okay, so then we can solve the more and more questions. Now we will discuss some more questions from the book. Exercise 1. Question number, how to solve the integer questions. Look here, -7, again minus, and -4 is given. So how to do? First we will write the -7. After that, minus into minus, that is my bracket. When the bracket is removed, the sign will be changed. That is minus, this one is minus. So minus into minus, sign will be plus. Minus into minus plus, so write down the O. And after that, remove the bracket. When you multiply the sign, then bracket will be removed. So you must know about this. After that, yes, you must. 4 minus 7, not 7, 4 minus 7, that is the just reverse of 7 minus 4, no? So real will be -2. 7 minus 4 You know when 7 minus 4, what is the 7 minus 4? All of you know 7 minus 4 is equal to 3. But according to this situation, that is 4 minus 7, na? Before 4, plus sign is here. Before 4, plus sign, it is not sign here. But you have to guess, if there is no sign of any number, then it will be always plus. Before 4, that is plus. Before 7, that is minus. Both are seven, same, na? These terms and these terms, both are same. It's no doubt. So, 4, 7 minus 4 is 3. But when we write 4 minus 7, guess your mind, that will be always your sign. So, it will be minus 3. So, that is the answer. Similarly, we will discuss another question. Look here, how to solve the another sum. Question number 2, minus 4 plus minus 3 minus minus 10. How to simplify? Minus 4 plus bracket close minus 3 minus minus 10. How to solve this? Very simple. You know when to solve this? Firstly, we have to remove the bracket. Then we can simplify easily. So how to simplify? How to solve? So write down minus 4 first. Plus into minus, minus 3. Remove the bracket. After multiplying, there should not be any bracket. Because you already multiplied, that is plus sign, plus into minus, according to the property. Plus into minus here, plus into minus, minus. So I already multiplied, that is plus into minus, minus 3. Again, minus into minus. What? Minus into minus, plus. Write down the plus sign, and it will be here. After that, minus 4 minus 3, minus 4 minus 3, minus 10, just like this. Yes, look here, 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. Similarly, minus 4, before 4 plus sign was there, minus 4 minus 3, it will be minus 7. So, before 4, that is plus sign, before 3, that is plus sign, 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. Similarly, before 4 minus, before 3 minus, it will be minus 7. So, it will be minus 7. Plus 10. After that, just simplify these parts. I have simplified only first parts. After that, I have written the plus sign. After simplifying this part, you have to write the plus sign. And after that, plus 10. Here, what will you do? Don't say 10 minus 7. You have to say this way. It's clear? You have to say this way, 10 minus 7. The real bit is 3. Don't write minus 7 plus 10 minus 3. No. 10 minus 7, 10 minus 7. Just like this. 10 minus 7 is equal to 3. Why, sir? Before 10 is plus. Here, before 10 is plus. Before 7 is minus. Before 7 is minus. So, definitely, this here will be 3. So, that is the answer. I hope all of you understood. We will discuss some more questions in next video. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.